Hey, welcome back to Albany County Fasteners, Fasteners 101. I'm Bob, and today we're going to talk about different grades and types of bolts. Let's get started. So I have an array here of different types of materials, and I want to go through the materials first, and we're going to give them the magnetic test. So I have a magnet here to show you. So first I have a 316 stainless, which is this one here. I have a 18/8 stainless, a brass hex cap screw, and a silicone bronze hex cap screw. This is hot dip galvanized. This is plain, grade 8 or better. Zinc plated hex cap screw. Another zinc hex cap screw, but in a different grade. So this is just a standard grade, but I'll go through the grades in a second. And I have a grade 8 zinc, yellow zinc coated. So I just wanted to give these a magnet test so you can see some are magnetized, others are not. This is a 316 stainless. And in this situation, there's no pull from the magnet. This is an 18/8, which has very little pull, as you can see, not much, but there is some partial magnetic field to that. This is brass. Brass has no magnetic field to it at all. Silicon bronze. This is silicon bronze. This is also, just so you know, used in heavy saltwater applications, such as on boats. This is a heavy used item for fasteners with saltwater day in and day out. No magnet ties on that. This is a hot dip galvanized hex cap screw. So this is alloyed steel and just coated with hot dip galvanized. And you can get some decent corrosion resistance out of that. And you can see the magnet sticks right to it. Grade 8, this is a grade 8 plain bolt, magnetized, zinc coated or plated. Another zinc plated, and then grade 8. You can see all of these have heavy magnet. So I just want to go through the different grades that we have. This is a grade 8 hex cap screw. You can tell by the markings on the head, but I'm going to show you even a better one. This is a large grade 8 bolt, and there you can see the markings. These markings on this head indicate these slashes. This 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, these 6 slashes that you see here, those slashes indicate that that's a grade 8 bolt. These letters that you're seeing is the manufacturer's markings. So they can identify should a bolt fail. They can identify that this is their bolt or not. So typically grade 8 in most cases is coated in yellow zinc. You can see this bolt, it's coated with a yellow zinc. These are typically grade 8s are heated to temperatures of 800 degrees. These are very commonly used in situations where you need a very strong bolt. I have here a grade 5 bolt. And you can see these 3 slashes. So 3 slashes on a grade 5 bolt. And you'll see again these letters These again are the manufacturer's letters. And you can see the grade 8. This is how you tell the difference, what you're buying. So when you go out and you're looking for a grade 5 bolt, you're always looking for the 3 slashes on the bolt. It's standard through the industry. This is a grade 2 bolt. This grade 2 bolt has no markings, no slashes at all. The only thing that you're going to see on here is the manufacturer's initials or his letters. This is a structural steel bolt, or they call this a structural bolt. You can get structural bolts, structural washers, and structural nuts. An A325, they have a 520, I think a 524 or 536 in nuts. But this is a structural bolt used in structural steel applications. These typically fall into the ASTM A193, which are typically heated somewhere about 1600 degrees and treated in that fashion. But I would refer you on to the ASTMs. These are also, just so you know, are plain and oiled finish. That's the only way, they do come in hot dip galvanized also, but the most common used is oil finish. As far as grades go, I was showing you the grades. Most plain bolts, other than structural, will have the grade 8 markings on them. Ours are grade 8 or better. And that's the way that they're indicated on our website, as grade 8 or better. And you will see the grade 8 slashes on the head. That will indicate, the 6 slashes will indicate that that's a grade 8 bolt and has been treated, heat treated throughout the bolt, so it is hard enough not to break for you. This I spoke to you before. Hot dip galvanized bolts are typically just grade 2 bolts, and they are treated and dipped into a hot dip galvanized bath, and they're brought out of the bath and then drained. Silicon bronze is, like I said, mostly used on boats, saltwater applications. They're used in electrical panels for many different reasons. This is very common in those applications. Brass, again, used in plumbing, hot water. These are typically have no heavy strength to them at all. You would find these to be the standard type 2 or equal to type 2 bolts. 18-8 stainless. 18-8, these are typically heated up to about 650 degrees when they're treated. They can range anywhere from a grade 2 to a grade 5, depending upon the manufacturer. And this is a grade 316 stainless. So silicon bronze are composed of copper, silicon, and other alloys, tin, zinc, iron, magnesium, which makes them corrosion resistant for marine and freshwater applications, and they're used in electrical panels, as I mentioned to you. You'll find alloyed steel, which is these here. Alloyed steel are made from high strength steel alloyed, heat treated. So that would be the grade 8. These are all alloyed. So grade 8, heat treated. So these, over time, just so you know, have a zinc finish on them, and they do not have any long-lasting rust resistance at all. Hot dip galvanized. Hot dip galvanized are from alloyed steel. They're dipped in molten zinc. These typically have to have thicker threads. You cannot use a zinc nut with a hot dip galvanized nut. It just won't go on properly and you're gonna have problems. So because of the hot dip galvanizing process is so thick, they have to adjust the threads so they properly properly coat the threads so there'll be rust resistance with the hot dip galvanizing. So I just wanted to bring up about the brass. The brass is solid brass, and with solid brass is copper and zinc. There is brass out there that they do use lead in. Lead is used today in many, many brass products. That's why in California there's a Prop 65 that we have to warn that could be cancerous. And we do bring that to everybody's attention in reference to brass. Brass is not always what they say or call a solid product. So I just wanted to bring that to your attention and educate you on the different grades and the different coatings along with different metals that are used. And I just want to brush over the different heat treatments. So with a grade 8, this falls under the SAE J429. So you can look that up to go over on Google. Just Google that and you'll find all the information in reference to the treatment of a grade 8 bolt. A grade 5 bolt falls under ASTM 574. A grade A325 falls under ASTM specifications also. Then you can look those up on Google to get further information. And that's our video for today. There you go. Subscribe, like, comment. Visit us at albanycountyfasteners.com for 50,000 SKUs right off the rack, ready to ship. We look forward to seeing you in our next video.